hidden underground only a few feet to around 100 feet beneath a fairly large section of Hawaii's Big Island is the world's longest lava tube. Here, the Kazumura Cave stretches for 40.7 miles or 65.5 kilometers in length, stretching from just east of the Kilauea volcano summit to a section of Hawaii's Paradise Park only 3 miles west of the ocean. Its rough outline I have overlaid onto Google Earth, although I must caution that this path has a high degree of error and might be off by a few thousand feet in some areas. Not only is the Kazumura Cave lava tube the longest on the planet, but it is also one of the planet's youngest such features, having only formed 580 years ago. This cave marks the dominant underground pathway magma took before erupting onto the surface at distant locations in one of Kilauea's most voluminous and island-changing eruptions. Known as the ʻAilāʻau eruption, this eruptive sequence, which occurred between 1410 and 1470, covered approximately 166 square miles in a fresh layer of lava. Due to the sheer scope of this event, which burned large swaths of rainforest, it was even suggested that this eruption was the direct source of the myth involving the Hawaiian god ʻAilāʻau, known as the fire god who devours forests. The ʻAilāʻau eruption began at the now-famed Kilauea Iki Crater, where lava initially erupted onto the surface in a towering lava fountain. After the gas content in this lava subsided, significant volumes of lava erupted in an almost completely effusive manner. As lava eventually overflowed from the newly formed crater, it slowly flowed towards the east, as this direction represented the steepest slope in the region. Pulled downhill by the force of gravity, lava crept towards the east, burning vegetation along the way and advancing at a speed of less than 1 mile per hour. Whereas initially the entire lava flow advanced as a solid mass, eventually sections of the flow developed where lava just naturally flowed at a faster speed, eventually becoming a singular dominant lava channel. After only a few days of eruptive activity, the lava flow thickness in the main lava channel had sufficiently increased, allowing for the construction of a lava tube to begin. This process began as the exterior of the growing lava flow, which was now largely inactive, started to cool, while the still moving interior remained molten. As bits of lava stuck to the edges of the lava tube, it slowly formed an overlying cooled mass, eventually fully enclosing the moving lava channel. Now fully enclosed, this lava tube continued to supply molten rock to more distant locations where the massive erupted lava was not yet thick enough to allow for the creation of a lava tube. This lava tube complex would remain active for 60 years, transporting lava at a speed of 5 to 15 miles per hour up to 20 miles to the east. Due to the sheer amount of lava this 60-year-long eruption had in place, totaling 6 cubic kilometers of molten rock, by 1470 it had drained so much of Kilauea's underlying magma chamber that it caused a breaking point to be reached. All of a sudden, a large mass of ground collapsed downwards to fill the empty space in the magma chamber, forming the first part of Kilauea's modern caldera. This collapse seemingly cut off the supply of fresh lava, causing the lava level in the lava tube to slowly decrease before stopping altogether as the eruption ended. Now, what remained was a large void space, which in the subsequent 400 plus years would experience 101 partial cave-ins of its roof, forming skylights that allowed for this lava tube system to be eventually found. Because of how recently this cave system was found, it makes you wonder if other such structures lie underground, not yet mapped, possibly even surpassing the length of this impressive complex. We haven't yet even fully mapped this cave complex, so Kazumura Cave, which was only discovered in 1966, has a decent chance it is even longer than the officially stated 40.7 mile length figure. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.